Hello, everyone, and welcome to State Hornet News. I'm Allison Mayhew.
And I'm Matt Gervin III.
It's been an eventful summer, and the State Hornet has been working to cover all the biggest stories that are impacting the Sac State community.
Here are some highlights of summer coverage you may have missed from the State Hornet Newsroom. Student renters who live at off-campus apartment complexes say they were pressured into renewing their leases as early as last December, leaving them stuck with their leases for the 2020-21 school year. Some said they want to get out of their leases because of financial hardship due to the coronavirus pandemic and health concerns living with random roommates. To get out of their leases, students are required to find a renter to take over their lease and pay a buyout fee.
Both the Big Sky and Big West athletic conferences have postponed fall sports competitions to the spring, pushing back many Sac State's team seasons. Teams whose seasons are impacted include football, men's and women's soccer, volleyball, and men's and women's cross country. Whether there will be winter sports is yet to be decided. Sac State President Robert Nelson said the conferences will work with the NCAA to try to plan for how to hold championships for fall sports in the spring.
Former Sac State quarterback Kevin Thomson, who spent three seasons with the Hornets, transferred to the University of Washington prior to the postponement of the 2020 football season. In 2019, Thomson led the Hornets to their first Big Sky championship, a trip to the FCS playoffs for the first time in school history, and won Big Sky Offensive Player of the Year.
Following Thomson's departure, Caden Bennett, a freshman quarterback from the University of Nevada, transferred to Sac State to compete for the starting quarterback job. Bennett graduated from Folsom High School, where he played for current Sac State coaches Chris Richardson and Bobby Fresquez.
Students and alumni from the theater and dance department confronted faculty about systemic racism they have faced within the department at Zoom meetings held over the summer. The meetings were called Be Free, which stands for Black Engaged Fundamental Racial Equity Every Day. At the meetings, students shared their negative experiences with faculty to start a conversation about changes that needed to be made in the department.
CSU Chancellor Timothy White answered students' questions about the upcoming semester during a virtual town hall meeting on August 19th, hosted by news organization Cal Matters. The State Hornet summarized key takeaways from the event in an article available in English and Spanish on our website, statehornet.com.
Joseph DeAngelo, widely known as the Golden State Killer, was sentenced to life in prison for the murder of 13 people and 13 kidnappings. DeAngelo also admitted to 131 other uncharged offenses of rape, burglary, abduction, and other crimes. DeAngelo's hearing and sentencing were both held in the Sacramento State University Union Ballroom this summer to allow for social distancing among a large number of DeAngelo's victims, their families, and the press.
That does it for this edition of State Hornet News. I'm Allison.
And I'm Mac. You can also send us news tips and story ideas to our Twitter handle, at the State Hornet, and follow us on Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. Have a great week, everybody.